course, that is the new video by Leanne Womack. And what we're doing today is we're talking about country music, where it's heading, who's hot, who's not, and the controversy of pop versus country, and where exactly does country music fit. Joining me right now is James Taylor from KIX 101.1 FM. You know what? You're face to the voice now, James.
Hey, you know what? It's nice to be here, Tammy. And I gotta say, this is the nicest kitchen I've ever seen. I didn't know you had such a nice kitchen.
Well, it's not ours, but
it's
there are
yours?
Some things that work here.
But. Oh, I tell you, you guys, just I was ready for some lunch, but nice to be here.
Well, not that kind of a show.
Okay.
Well, what we're here today talking about is country music, of course. It's your life, I guess you could say.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we can start off by saying, who is hot right now?
Who is hot?
Who's
well,
hot?
Of course, we're just coming off Dauphin Country Fest,
yeah.
Another very successful Dauphin Country Fest a couple of weeks ago. And this thing has just grown over the last 10 years. It's actually one of Canada's premier outdoor festivals now. And I don't think country music could be any stronger as it is right now. We had Lone Star, who of course had the big song of 1999. And you know, in an industry that is fueled by so much money spent on promoting the artist, they basically took the back door in, and without a lot of fanfare and a lot of publicity, they scored the number one song of the year, single and song of the year. So I mean, it's been a really good year for bands like that. Canadian artist,
yes,
Amanda Stott. Amanda Stott, I mean, here's a girl who's only 18 years of age, and she's had just an amazing career in the last 2 years. She's been signed with one of the biggest record labels in the industry. And now she's, I understand, closing down Portage Avenue, Portage Main.
That's tonight, actually.
Tonight
yeah, for the Winnipeg Blue Bomber
kickoff. So I think that's
she's
wonderful.
She's performing, so that's good for her. Now, where is the music industry headed? Because there's been a lot of talk about whether or not country is truly country anymore, because you hear people like Faith Hill, Shania Twain, even Lone Star on radio stations like yours and radio stations that are pop stations.
Right, and there is definitely a crossover element into a lot of stations both sides of the border right now. And my take on that is, you know, you got to make room for the new artists. I mean, 20 or 30 years ago, there was the Merle Haggards, there was the Johnny Cashes, and I mean, if you think about it, Buck Owens was the first guy to play electric guitar at the Grand Ole Opry, and everybody was just appalled, and then people got used to it. And, you know, you got to make room for the new artists. And, I mean, these people are still selling records. Kenny Rogers just scored a big number one single after, 20 or 30 years. So, but it's an industry that a lot of money is spent promoting the artists now, and I don't really find a problem with crossover. There are some people like the Faith Hills that are using a lot more production in the studios when it comes to time to record the CD, but it's what's selling, and the bottom line is it's what people like, and all the calls that we get at the station is from all generations of people, and they're liking what they hear, and if they're liking what they're hearing, we're going to continue doing.
Is it going to continue that way with the studio sound, a very produced sound?
I think so. It really is amazing what they can do in a production studio nowadays. I mean, they can really EQ your voice, they can make you sound terrific. But I mean, there's got to be some element of talent, obviously, to get to that point in this industry. And I did an interview with actually Jamie Warren, who's a well-established recording artist, just a couple of years ago, and he said the same thing. You know, there are people complaining about the Johnny Cashes, the Merle Haggards, who are kind of not being heard as much on FM radio nowadays. But these guys are still selling records, and they're still with their big labels. And Kenny Rogers, he's got his own record label now, and that's the reason why he scored this huge hit. And but you've got to make room for these these young kids. I tell you, these kids are taking over now. These young, like Lila McCann, we've got Amanda Stott. Adam Gregory,
who's on the radio this afternoon, actually.
He's going to be actually joining me this afternoon. He's a new guy out of
Edmonton,
Sony recording artist. He signed with Sony last year, and he's only 14 years of age.
But you know, when you hear a song, Horseshoes, on the radio.
And you wouldn't think.
I thought the guy was in his late 20s.
Exactly.
He's got such a deep voice.
It's amazing. We all thought that. We couldn't believe when we found out that his birth certificate was, 1970. I mean,
you have to see the video to believe it.
It's incredible. He's young enough to be my son. That's how I'm really aging myself now. But he's done very well. He's still in ninth grade. So that's the tough part, is balancing your school days along with a music career. And you got to be serious about this business, because when you jump onto a big label like that, they pull a lot of strings for you. And they have to if they want to promote you to be a serious recording artist. But It's a very interesting business right now. And Minnie Pearl once said, as far as fans go, country music fans are the most loyal fans.
Yes, that's true.
In any genre of music, mm-hmm. they really are. I mean, if you love them, they'll love you back. And I've had the pleasure of being at Dauphin Country Fest for the last 3 years now, and it's just amazing. It doesn't matter what backgrounds you're from or what's going on in your life. People are there to have a good time, and country music is about real people. It really is. It's about real life stories. And it's stories that people can relate to, whether they're on the fields or perhaps they're going through a tough time as far as relationships.
Or in the middle of downtown, in a city, in a Canadian city downtown, that's right. Now, definitely. What you brought here, you brought some hats from KIX.
Aren't these nice, Tammy?
They're very nice. They're
embroidered
that's
and everything.
That's the new logo. Now, how long have you been FM for?
We've been FM since about March. Yeah.
So since March.
And it's been just a great move for us.
All right, right now, we want to give away these hats. Now, James gave you the answer a little bit earlier on.
That was a clue.
Sneaky of you, I know. Right now, we're taking the first Brandon caller and the first out-of-town caller at 728-3312. You have to be able to answer this question. What was the biggest country music song of 1999? Now, James did mention who it was a little bit earlier on.
Snuck it out.
Snow Song.
Little clue.
So if you can give us a call right now and you have that answer, then you get yourself a KIX ball cap.
Yeah.
Very good.
Nice.
Just before we go, mm-hmm. I just wanted to ask you what your prediction is. Look into your crystal ball.
Mm-hmm.
Who is going to be the it person for next year?
Oh, sure. Now there's a question. Now, of this year?
Yep. Tell me who we're going to be talking about.
Okay. You know what? I think this year it's going to be a banner year for Lone Star. And the Dixie Chicks.
Oh,
caught their
the
show
Dixie
in Winnipeg,
Chicks.
5 stars. I mean, I've never seen so many people sing along to so many songs. It was just incredible. So I'll say the Dixie Chicks, okay. And I'll say Lone Star.
That's a pretty safe bet there, James.
Geez.
Thank you very much for joining us today.
My
I wish
pleasure.
We had more time. This
Absolutely.
Is wonderful. And of course, you can hear James and all the other wonderful DJs on 101.1 on your FM dial. That is KIX Country. All right, we'll be back to say goodbye. But first, here's a look at what's happening around the region.